The meaning of a name is subtext, my rabbi would always say. I always remember the meaning of the names in our history, like Moses means to be drawn out, as he was drawn out from the River Nile as a baby. And then later he drew out the Israelites from Egypt for their freedom. King David, his name means beloved, as he was a man after God's own heart. The meaning of a name is subtext. I had this in mind as I stood in the courtyard. Hours before, my family and I, we had been celebrating the Passover, when suddenly we heard the screams from the crowd of two names, Jesus and Barabbas. I had heard of Jesus only by reputation. His teachings, his claims, even his miracles were the subject of many heated conversations and controversies, even with us Jews. I hadn't made up my mind about him yet. He was peaceful enough, but his teachings, they kind of rippled into this potential violence. After all, he did claim that God, our God, has a father, which no one had ever done. And not only that, he claimed that it was his father. So naturally, the crowd shouted, "Crucify him!" Because no one can claim to be God's son and live. Now Barabbas I knew of. He was a hero to the zealots. You see, he was a murderer and a rioter of the Romans who ruled over us by brutal means. So before us were two options, Jesus and Barabbas. Jesus, whose name means God who saves, and then Barabbas, Bar Abba, which means the son of the father. How ironic. For Jesus was being put to death for precisely the meaning of Barabbas' name. Pilate addressed the crowd. "Should I give you Barabbas or Jesus, King of the Jews?" You see, the Romans, to show good faith, would release a Jewish prisoner by the Jewish popular vote right before the Passover feast. So, I mean, I figured with Jesus' conviction by the Pharisees that he would still be set free by the crowd. I mean, with all the people that he had healed and delivered from demons and even just helped get right with God, surely those people were here and ready to be his voice and bring him to freedom. And the crowd almost in unison shouted, "Bring us Barabbas!" I was in shock. They wanted to free the murderer. I looked at Jesus to defend himself, and he just stayed there silent. What was he doing? Pilate seemed uneasy, but he released Barabbas. Barabbas was unchained and pushed into the crowd by the guards. I didn't understand what was happening. The guards, they led Jesus back into the palace prison. And I wanted to shout, "Wait! What has this man done? What crimes has he committed?" But no words came out of my mouth. Only self-preservation. I scanned the crowd looking for Barabbas, but he had disappeared into the chaos, probably hiding in case Pilate changed his mind. Jesus Christ carried Barabbas' cross. He took Barabbas' place. Don't you understand? If Jesus had not been crucified that day, Barabbas would have been. Don't you see? You are Barabbas. You deserve death for your crimes until Jesus took your place. He became sin who knew no sin. He took your death upon himself so that you may have abundant life today. You are pardoned. You are loved. You are free. And not only did this God who saves save you, but he gave you a birthright that you never deserved. For he calls you Barabbas, the son of the Father.